Hey guys, welcome back to Auto Repair Guys. Thank you guys for watching and subscribing to the channel. In today's video here, we'll be working on a BMW guys 3 Series. So if you have a BMW 3 Series guys, and we'll demonstrate on E90, E91, 92, 93. But even if you have a E46 or anything like that, newer generation 3 Series guys, and you're wondering, okay, what are the symptoms of a bad knock sensor? Stay with us, super important video. We'll cover everything from start to finish today, guys. What are the symptoms of a bad knock sensor? Now, on 4-cylinder engines, you may have one or two. On 6-cylinder engines, you have two knock sensors usually, guys. Quick introduction to the channel. Every single car we get at the shop, we make at least 200 free repair videos. Specifically on BMWs, we make close to 400-500 videos. Why we guys do all that? Simply because our mission at the shop is to save you as much money as we can. All we need in return, guys, please subscribe to the channel and like the video so we can keep providing that free information. Now, if you guys need to buy new replacement knock sensors, or if you need to buy, guys, two parts to fix your vehicle, check out the links, all the things that we use, guys. We share the links where we get them from for your convenience. So, specifically, guys, this is a 2006 BMW N52 engine, 6-cylinder engine, one of the most popular engines that you can find built, guys, especially in the US between year 2005 and year 2015. So, this is, guys, the engine, 6-cylinder engine. Before we get to the symptoms of knock sensors, we want to show you where they're located. Usually, guys, you will need to remove the intake manifold to get to the knock sensors, okay, and they're located right here. You can see this is for bank 1, the first half of the engine block, and bank 2 for the second half of the engine block. Bank 1, bank 2. Those are the knock sensors, guys. However, you replace both of them at the same time because they have one connector only, so you will need to replace both of them at the same time. Now, you will need to remove most likely your intake manifold to get to them, and when you remove the intake manifold, and when you remove the knock sensors, you're super close to the positive wire coming from the car battery going to the engine starter and the alternator. And if you touch that wire, guys, with the tool, you're going to short things out. You can burn the engine computer module. So disconnect the car battery, guys. Okay, you can even catch your car on fire. Disconnect the car battery. Now, another thing, guys, if you do not know the correct way to disconnect the car battery, let's say which battery terminal to disconnect and reconnect first, we have a video that explains all that, and we'll have the link in the description of the video below. Also, we'll have a link to the video that explains how to remove the intake manifold. So, the knock sensors, guys, what they do? Okay, when your engine is running, okay, let me explain quick. It's getting fuel, okay, and fuel and air. Okay, it could be gasoline, it could be diesel. Modern diesel engines, they have knock sensors as well. And as a result, guys, okay, that fuel and air, okay, is going to be compressed by the piston, and then the ignition timing, the spark plug, okay, is going to ignite, okay, it will make explosion, it will move the piston down, and that creates power. Now, if that that explosion happens too early, it's called detonation, guys, what will happen, actually, it's going to be too early, guys, and it will develop that knock, kind of like vibration, and it will be caught by the knock sensors. Now, it's very important the knock sensors detect that, and the knock sensors will tell the engine computer, okay, we need to change the timing of the ignition, so the spark plugs, when to be activated, a little bit early, a little bit late, to adjust that. So that way, guys, you will not cause damage to your engine, because if you keep driving with a bad sensor, okay, what will happen? You can burn valves, you can say bye-bye to your engine, guys, you can do quite a bit of damage. But what are the first symptoms when they go out? Okay, number one, engine light will be on most of the times. Number two, guys, slow acceleration, hesitation, jerking, kind of like, you know, the engine will hesitate, all of a sudden will start going, and at certain RPMs it can hesitate again. You will notice pure fuel economy, guys. Your car will use more fuel than usual, okay? That's number one reason probably that you will notice that a knock sensor is bad. And you can even kind of like hear an engine knock yourself, okay, under hard acceleration, especially in lower gear too, like, let's say, in higher gear, like, let's say you're climbing uphill going fourth or fifth, you can definitely hear that knock a little bit as well. But things to look at: hesitation, rough idle, jerking, poor fuel economy, guys, and engine light. Those are the top 5 reasons associated with knock sensors. So thank you for watching, guys. Please subscribe to the channel for more help, and see you guys next time.